everyone, this is Jennifer. This video we're going to look into the next part of our comparative statement, which is the comparative balance sheet. So what do we do in a comparative balance sheet is we analyze the same items or a group of items and compute items in two or more balance sheet of the same concern on two different dates. The changes can be observed by computing the balance sheet at the beginning and at the end of the period with the help of these opinions. The opinions can be formed above the progress of an enterprise. So in this comparative balance sheet, we basically analyze a trend between the items of 2 years balance sheet. That's all in simple words. We basically take 2 years balance sheet, okay, of the same company, and we compare what is the trend. Trend means, is it an increase or a decrease in the items of the balance sheet. So this is a format of a comparative balance sheet. So a comparative balance sheet format starts first with equity and liability. So first we start ahead with your liability side, then we move ahead with your asset side. So first, there are basically 5 columns. You have your particulars, then your current year, which is your present year, your previous year or your base year, then increase or decrease. If there's an increase when compared to your current year and previous year, you'll show it an increase. If there is an amount decrease with your current year and previous years, you will show it as decrease. For example, last year it was 15,000 and this year it is 20,000. Assume share capital. Okay, that time what happened? There is a increase. Okay, 5,000. So you put it in increase column. So percentage increase or decrease, you will calculate your percentage of increase. Okay, you will show the amount here in your fourth column and you will show your percentage increase in your fifth column. So you start with shareholders fund. First is your preference share capital and your equity share capital. So what is a share capital? A share capital basically is the amount of shares that a company issues in order to raise capital for the company. So there are two different kinds of shares. One is your preference shares, the other one is your equity shares. Equity shares are nothing but your owners of the company. Preference shares are nothing but who have a preference over the redemption period or while redeeming your shares at the time of repayment of shares. Then we move on to the general reserve. So any reserves and surplus of the companies which are categorized as a capital reserve, debenture redemption reserve, securities premium, etc., will come under this category. Then you have your dividend equalization fund. So dividend equalization fund or reserve can be a distributable reserve which is specifically maintained in order to ensure that dividends remain stable irrespective of what the earnings of the company is. So those funds will come under this category. Then you have your statutory reserves, all the other reserves. So these are the reserves which are maintained by any financial institution like bank or insurance company in order to meet their unmatured obligations or for the repayment of their obligations, okay, like repayment of the amounts to the clients, etc. Then you have other reserves of funds. So under other reserves of funds, you have various reserves like your debenture redemption reserve, security premium reserve, etc. Then you have your profit and loss. So the surplus, so the profit will be considered. Then you have your total shareholders funds. So we move on to your total shareholders funds. So the next category is your non-current liabilities. So under that you have your long-term debts. So the long-term debts, under that we have your mortgage loans or debentures. So the borrowings of the company mostly are in the form of two. One is your bonds and the other one is your debentures, and the other terms will be termed as long-term loans. So So your mortgage loan, debentures, then your long-term loans. Then we get our total of long-term debts. Then we move on to our short-term liabilities, which is our current liabilities. Under that, you have your bills payable, creditors, any bank overdraft, then accrued expenses, then any provisions made by the company. Then you total up your total current liabilities, which is your C. Then you total up all the three categories of your liabilities side, which is A, B and C. What is your A? A is nothing but your total shareholders funds plus your total long-term debts plus your total current liabilities. Then we move on to our asset side, which is your non-current asset. Under that, we have categorized into two types. One is your fixed asset, the other one is your current asset. Under your fixed asset, all the assets which are long-term in nature will come under your fixed assets, like your land and building, plant and machinery, furniture fixtures, computers. If there are any goodwill, that will also come here, patents, the intangible assets and other fixed assets. Then we total up our total fixed assets. Then we move on to our next category, which is our current asset. So under that you have cash in hand, bills receivable, debtors, stock, other current liabilities, and you total up your current asset. So when you total up your asset side, we get your total fixed assets plus your total current asset. So now let us look into our first question, which is, from the following information, prepare a comparative balance sheet and comment on the position. So they have given equity, share capital, debentures, sundry debtors, bank overdraft. Whatever items are there in your balance sheet, that will what will be given in your comparative balance sheet statements. So you will consider only those items. Then they have given the total liabilities and capital. Then they have given the asset side, which is plant and machinery is your fixed asset, land and building fixed asset, investment is your fixed asset, sundry debtors is your current asset, and cash in hand is your current asset. So let us look into our solution part. Comparative balance sheet. So we start with shareholders fund. Under shareholders fund, what do we have in the question that is given? Equity, share capital. So what is your previous year? First, when you look into your question, the first thing that you're supposed to look in, what is your base year? What is your current year? Your base year is what? 2003, which is your previous year. What is your current year? 2004. Okay. So first will be your previous year amount. The second will be your current year amount. So equity share capital they have given. So you will categorize it under your shareholders fund, equity share capital. Last year it is 4 lakh. The current year it is 6 lakhs. So what is your increase or decrease? So when you compare with your last year and current year, it has increased from last year to current year. How much it has increased? 2 lakhs. Okay, 6 lakh minus 4 lakh is 2 lakhs. Since it is an increase, you'll put it in plus sign. So you add it in your plus sign, which is plus 2 lakhs. Okay. So now you have to show your percentage increase or decrease. So whenever it is increase, you will show it in plus sign. Whenever it is a decrease, you will show it in minus sign. That is as simple as that. Signs, you never get confused. Whenever it is an increase, you will show it in plus sign. Whenever it is a decrease, you will show it in minus sign. So how do you do your percentage increase? How much is your increase? 2 lakhs divided by your base year amount, which is 4 lakhs into 100. I will show it in Excel. So your increase is 2 lakhs is equal to 2 lakhs divided by, what is your base year amount? 4 lakhs. 4 lakhs into 100, because it is percentage. So how much do you get? 50%. So you put it as 50%. Now your total shareholders funds, you'll total it up. Since it's a one item is there, so you take the item as usual, 4 lakhs, 6 lakhs, 2 lakhs plus 50%. Now we move on to non-current liabilities. Under non-current liabilities, in the question they have given debentures, which is your long-term debts. So last year it is 2 lakhs, this year it is 3,25,000. So if you see, there is an increase of 1,25,000. So 3,25,000 minus 2 lakhs, which is 1,25,000. 1,25,000 divided by 2 lakhs into 100. I will again repeat, what is your increase? 1,25,000 divided by what is your base year amount? 2 lakhs. So 2 lakhs into 100. How much do you get? 62.50%. So you total it up, you total bring your 2 lakhs, 3,25,000, 1,25,000. So you get your percentage increase as same. Don't total everything because we are going as per section by section. Current liabilities under that, in the question they have given sundry creditors. Last year it is 2,55,000. The current year it is 1,17,000. So if you see last year to this year, there is a decrease. How much is your decrease? 2,55,000 minus 1,17,000, which is 1,38,000. Since it is a decrease, you will put it in minus sign. So what is your percentage of decrease? 1,38,000 divided by 2,55,000 into 100, which is 54.12%. Then your next item that they have given in the question is bank overdraft. Last year it is 7,000, the current year it is 10,000. Is it an increase or a decrease? It has increased. How much it has increased? 10,000 minus 7,000, which is 3,000. So what is your percentage of increase? Since it is increased, we'll put it in plus sign. Percentage of increase is 3,000 divided by 7,000 into 100, which you'll get 42.86%. Now your total current liability total up, 2,55,000 plus 7,000, 2,62,000, 1,17,000 plus 10,000, 1,27,000, 1,38,000 minus 1,38,000 plus 3,000. So when you come to your calculation, it will be minus 1,35,000. How? You will take your higher value sign, which is minus, plus into minus is minus, so you will subtract it. Plus and minus, take your higher value sign, which is minus, plus into minus is minus, so you will subtract it. 54.12 minus 42.86, which is 51.53. Or you can do it like this also. 2,62,000 minus 1,27,000. It has decreased, so it is 1,35,000, which is minus. 1,35,000 divided by 2,62,000 into 100, it is 51.53%. Now you total up all your liabilities. How will you total up all your liabilities? Is total of your shareholders' funds plus total of your long-term debts plus total of your current liabilities. Now we are moving on to our asset side. Under that we have two types of asset. One is your fixed assets, the other one is your current asset. So under fixed asset, in the question we have plant and machinery, land and building, investments. So plant and machinery, you have 1 lakh last year, the current year it is 2 lakhs. Since it is an increase, you will have put plus sign and the increase is 1 lakh. 1 lakh divided by 1 lakh into 100, you will get 100% as your increase. Land and building, last year it is 3,60,000, current year it is 5,40,000. So it is an increase, which is 1,80,000. So 1,80,000 divided by 3,60,000, which will get 50%. Investment, last year it is 2,70,000, the current year it is 1,70,000. It is a decrease, so you'll put it in minus sign. The decrease amount is 1 lakh. So 1 lakh divided by 2,70,000 into 100, you get 37%. You total up your fixed assets, then you move on to your current asset. Under current asset, you have sundry debtors and cash in hand. Sundry debtors, last year it is 1 lakh, the current year it is 88,000. So it is a decrease of 12,000. So decrease is 12,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100, which is 12%. Cash in hand, last year it is 54,000. Last year it is 32,000. The current year it is 54,000. So it is an increase of how much? 22,000. So 22,000 divided by 32,000 into 100, which you get 69%. total of your current asset, you will total it up, total asset side A and B. So you should total up your current fixed assets and your current asset. So now if you see your total liabilities, the total of your liabilities and the total of your asset will always be the same. Okay, because it is a balance sheet, always your asset and your liabilities will balance, right? So your comparative balance sheet also will tally in the same way. Your asset value and your liabilities value will be tallying. So it will be the same percentage of increase or decrease, and it will be the same amount of increase or decrease. So if you get only when it is tallying, you get to know that the answer is correct. So interpretation, your comparative balance sheet given above reveals that there is an increase. So you can basically, in your comparative statement interpretation, you should basically show, is it an increase or a decrease and how it will affect the company. So there is an increase of 1,80,000 in fixed assets. However, long-term debts is increased by 1,25,000 and share capital also has increased by 2 lakhs. Thus, long-term sources are used for financing additional working capital. So if you see your fixed asset has increased, okay, you have purchased something from your fixed asset, and simultaneously if you see your long-term debts and your share capital also has increased. By this we get to know that using your long-term debts and your share capital amount, you are buying your fixed asset. So your long-term sources are used for financing additional working capital also. Then if you see, the total current asset has increased by 10,000, whereas current liability is decreased by 51.53%. So you're basically comparing your current asset and current liabilities to show whether it's an increase or a decrease, whether the company is liably increasing its liabilities or whether the company is increasing its assets. So the conclusion, the firm used long-term sources for working capital finance. It is better to raise current liability to meet current asset. So basically the company, the comparative balance sheet is telling the long-term sources have increased. So which, and your current liability is decreased. So when long-term sources are increased and your current liability is decreased, the company is basically using the long-term sources to meet its short-term finances. Okay, so this should not happen in a company. The company should always raise its current liability to meet its current assets. So that is what is our conclusion. So going on to our next question, which is, from the following balances, prepare comparative balance sheet showing increase or decrease in individual assets and liabilities together with percentage of such increase or decrease and comment. So from the following balances, prepare comparative balance sheet showing increase or decrease in individual assets and liabilities together with percentage of such increase or decrease and comment. So you have your share capital. Share capital will come under your shareholders fund. Reserves, which will also come under your shareholders funds. Then your secured loans, which is your long-term liabilities. Unsecured loans, long-term liabilities. Sundry creditors, which is your current liabilities. So till here it is your liabilities side. Now we are moving on to our asset side. Buildings, which is our fixed assets. Machinery, fixed assets. Stock, current asset. Debtors, current asset. Cash at bank, current asset. So your base year is 2000 and your current year is 2001. So you start with your comparative balance sheet. So your shareholders fund, under that you have your share capital. Last year 8 lakh, current year it is 10 lakh. So the increase is 2 lakhs. Show it in your plus sign. So plus 2 lakh. 2 lakh divided by 8 lakhs into 100, 25%. Reserves, last year 1 lakh, current year 1,20,000. So your increase is 20,000. 20,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100, 20% is your increase. So your total, your share capital side. Then you move on to your non-current liabilities. Under that we have our long-term liabilities. Under that we have secured loans, which is 30,000 last year. Current year it is 40,000. So your increase is how much? 10,000. So 10,000 divided by 30,000 into 100, 33.33%. Unsecured loans, last year it is 20,000, current year it is 10,000, it has decreased, so minus 10,000. So 10,000 divided by 20,000 into 100, it is minus 50%. So moving on to our current liabilities, under that we have sundry creditors. Last year it is 80,000, the current year it is 1 lakh. So increase is how much? 20,000. So 20,000 divided by 80,000 into 100, the percentage of increase is 25%. So your total are of your current liabilities. Now you total up all your subheadings, which is your total of your shareholders' funds plus total of your long-term liabilities plus total of your current liabilities, you get 10,30,000, 12,70,000. So 12,70,000 minus 10,30,000, 2,40,000 is your increase. 2,40,000 divided by 10,30,000 into 100, which is 23.30, is your increase percentage. Now moving on to our asset side, under that you have your fixed assets and your current asset. So fixed asset, building. Last year it is 4 lakh, current year it is 5 lakhs. So 1 lakh is your increase, 1 lakh divided by 4 lakh into 100, which is 25%. Machinery, last year it is 3 lakh, the current year it is 4 lakh. Your increase is 1 lakh, 1 lakh divided by 3 lakhs into 100, which is 33.33%. Total up your fixed assets. Now moving on to a current asset, under that we have stock. Last year it is 1 lakh, this year it is 1,80,000. Your percentage decreases 20,000. 20,000 divided by 2 lakhs into 100, minus 10%. Debtors, last year it is 1 lakh, the current year it is 1,50,000. So your percentage increases 50,000. 50,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100. Percentage of increase is 50%. Cash at bank, last year it is 30,000, the current year it is 40,000. Percentage increases 10,000. Sorry, amount increases 10,000. Percentage increase is 10,000 divided by 30,000 and 100, 33.33%. Total up your current asset. Now you total up your asset side, which is your fixed assets and liabilities. If you see the total of your equity and liability and the total of your asset side will be the same. Okay. Interpretation, in the above comparative statement, fixed asset increased by 2 lakh, 28.57% in return. There is no long-term liability increased. However, share capital has increased by 24%. So the company used its working capital finance to meet its long-term obligation. So if you see, the fixed asset has increased when compared to your share capital, meaning to tell your working capital, your current asset has been used for your long-term liabilities, and your current asset is increased by 40,000, whereas your current liabilities are increased by 25%. Current asset increase is not equal to your current liability increase, so the short-term sources are diverted to your by your fixed asset. So since it is not balanced, then where are the remaining amounts going? Why are you increasing your current liabilities? Because you are using it for your fixed asset. Conclusion, it is not suggested to use working capital finance to long-term assets. The business can use long-term debts to buy fixed asset, otherwise the company will have to face shortage of working capital. Always your long-term debts will be used for purchase of your fixed assets, and your current liabilities will be used for your current asset. Okay, moving on to our next question. With the help of the company's balance sheet, study the financial position of M Limited for the year 2008 and 2009 using comparative balance sheet technique. So they have given the liabilities side and they have given the asset side. Okay. Now we have in liability side 6% redeemable cumulative preference share. So your preference share will come under your shareholders fund. Then 6.5% redeemable cumulative preference share capital. Again, it is a preference share capital which will come under your shareholders fund. Then equity share, which is your ordinary share, shareholders fund. Then you have your reserves, and then they have given your capital, which is your ordinary share capital, which will come under your shareholders fund subheading. Then you have your reserves, which will also come under your shareholders fund. Profit and loss account, it will come under your shareholders fund. Then you have your loans and advances, which is your long term liabilities. Then you have your sundry creditors, which is your current liabilities, provision for tax, current liabilities, customers' credit balance, current liabilities, unclaimed dividend, the dividend which is not claimed by the company, it is a current liability, claimed for the company, which is a current liability, a provision for proposed dividend, current liability, provision for contingent liability, contingent liability, which is a current liability, provision for gratuity accruals, current liabilities, which is a interest on security. Now moving on to your asset side, in the question itself they have subdivided and given as fixed assets and current assets, so you can take it as it is. Now is your comparative balance sheet. So comparative balance sheet, so under equity and liabilities you have your under shareholders fund you have your 6% redeemable cumulative preference share. Last year it is 2500, the current year it is 2500. If both the amounts are same, then there is no increase or decrease, it will be a nil figure. So 6.5% redeemable cumulative preference share capital, last year nil, the current year it is 3000. So which means from zero figure it has moved down to 3000 as your amount. So it is an increase of your amount, which is 3000. So 3000 divided by nothing, okay, you have nothing as your last year, into 100, so it is a 100% increase. Next is your ordinary share capital. Last year it is 5500, the current year it is 13200, so it is an increase of 7700. 7700 divided by 5500 into 100, which is 140%. Reserves, last year it is 2500, the current year it is 3450. So 3450 divided by 2500 into 100, which is 38%. Profit and loss account, last year it is 116, the current year it is 99. So what is your decrease? Minus 17. So 17 divided by 116 into 100, which is 14.66%. Moving on to our non-current liabilities, under that we have long-term liabilities. Under that, in the question, we have only the loans and advances. So last year it is 71,745. The current year it is 51,282. So if you see, it has decreased. So decrease amount is how much? 20,463. So 20,463 divided by 71,745 into 100, 28.52%. So your total of your long term liability is 71,745, 51,282, and it is a minus figure of 20,463. And a minus percentage of decrease, which is 28.52%. Now moving on to our current liabilities, under that we have sundry creditors. Last year it is 27,122, current year it is 14,734. It is a decrease amount of 12,388. So decrease percentages 12,388 divided by 27,122, which is 45.68%. Provision for tax, The decrease amount is for 434. Percentage is 434 divided by 5012 into 100, which is 8.66%. Customers' credit balance last year it is 1603, current year it is 2079. So percentage of increase is 476. 476 divided by 1603 into 100, which is 29.69. Unclaimed dividend last year it is 6, current year it is 107, so it is increase of 101. So 101 divided by 6 into 100%, which is 168.3% of increase. Provision for proposed dividend last year it is 1113, the current year it is 1420. There's a increase amount of 307. So increase percentage is 307 divided by 1113 into 100, which is 27.58%. So same way we will calculate for provision for contingent liability, which you get 8% increase. Provision for gratuity is 100% increase because last day it was nil figure, there was no amount. Accruals, it is 65.90%. You will total up your current liabilities. When you total up your shareholders fund current liability and your long term liability, you get your amount, and the percentage of decrease is, it is minus. Okay, here they have put it as plus by mistake. It is a minus figure of 17.82%. Now moving on to your asset side, you under that you have your fixed assets and your current asset. Fixed assets less depreciation, they have given us 9,705, and the current year it is 11,032. So your percentage increase is 1,327. Your percentage of increase is 13.67%. Investment last year it is 1,947. The current year it is 2,429. Percentage increase is 24.76. I'm sure all of you all would now know how to calculate your percentage increase and your amount increase. So moving on to our current asset, under that we have receivables, percentage increase is 30.15. advance payment of tax, percentage increase is 12.49. cash in bank, it is a decrease because last year and this year the comparatively the amount has decreased, so it is minus 22.03. sundry debtors also has decreased by 12.72%. stock in trade also has decreased by 29.74%. store spare parts and tool has increased by 8.4%. Now you'll total up your current asset, and when you total up your current asset and current fixed asset, you get your total asset. So your total asset will always be equal to your total liabilities. Interpretation, you will always compare how your fixed assets, your long term debts and your shareholders funds, the percentage increase should always be equal. If it is not equal, then you should see why is it not equal. So the fixed asset has increased by so 15%, whereas long term debts has decreased. So which means you have not used your long term debts for buying fixed asset, and your shareholders fund has increased just by 1%. So again it is a very less increase, which basically shows that you have raised short term funds to pay your or to buy your fixed asset, and your current asset has decreased by 21.47% compared to the last year. So basically you will compare your current asset and current liabilities and show whether you have used your long-term debts and your shareholders funds to buy your fixed assets, and is your current asset and current liability percentage increase are same or not. Thank you everyone.